Well, surprise, 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 Patrick.
Happy birthday, Dad.
Happy 60th birthday, Dad. Courtney and I came up with 3 questions pertaining to you.
It's been a time, Patrick. It's recently, I got a chance to come to Detroit, and we see, I went to Patrick's Friday, we cooked breakfast, and we just talked about all the good times and all the people we knew in our lives. It was so, we talked for a couple hours, just enjoying laughing and joking about all the good times we had, and all the different families and all the people we knew. That was the best time I could remember. We just had a ball.
You know, it's really hard to say, you know, my favorite memories with my brother, my big brother, that I have spent my entire life with. We did everything together. I can't really think of a time where you didn't let me come hang out. You didn't treat me like I was a little kid. You always took me with you, showed me a good time, hang out, and treat me like a person. One of my best memories as an adult is that when the family had a Secret Santa, no matter how many times we saw each other during the year, we always spent Christmas Eve going out shopping. No matter where I am Christmas Eve, no matter what I'm doing, I'm still thinking about those times we spent together.
One of my fondest memories of you is picking me up from school, getting me on the weekends so that I could spend time with you and your family.
Hey, Patrick, we made it to 60. Oh my gosh, I didn't think we were gonna make it, but we did. I've known you since 1978. We were teenagers. It's been an incredible journey. I'm so thankful that I had the journey with you. And my most favorite memory of you is the Big Six. My 3 kids and my 3 grandchildren, they are the center and highlight of my life. And I want to thank you for allowing me to be their mother.
I have to say, Dad, you and I share a lot of memories, especially in the most recent years with us working together. When I was a child, you and I did father-daughter dances together at Artistry in Motion. Then when I played AAU basketball, you would take me to basketball practice every Tuesday and Thursday. In high school, you taught me how to drive. Then once I became an adult, every Sunday morning, we would wake up early, go clean the our different little accounts through Coverall. And now, we work together at the plant. So I've enjoyed that. I spend a lot of time with you. So I don't really have a favorite moment because I feel like every moment I'm with you, I enjoy driving in the car, listening to Amy Winehouse and Miguel. Just so many little moments that are all special to me and I feel like are dear to me. The little things and the small moments mean a lot. You buying us donuts every Saturday before you can take us to get our hair done. Like, just a lot of things you did.
So, my most favorite memory with you would have to be going to the Easter market on Saturday morning and going to the antique shop. I remember, even though we would go super early, I always enjoyed our time together. We would go to the antique shop and just look around, and I would think about different things that I could do with these secondhand furniture items, and you would say, yeah, you know, we can paint it and we can do that and it'll work. So I always enjoyed that. And then afterwards we would go and get some candy together. So I enjoyed those times where it was just me and you together.
My favorite memory with you would have to be just sitting on the couch, watching TV and talking with you. But another memory that's like my absolute fave was waking up early with you, helping you, Amber and Courtney, clean up the little businesses that you guys used to clean up. And I was like 8 or 9, so I thought it was so cool because I got to work with my grandpa and my aunties. Yeah, that was my favorite memory with you.
One of my favorite memories with Grandpa is when I was younger, every weekend we would go to McDonald's to get a blueberry pomegranate smoothie.
I've had so much fun with you over the years, and
my favorite time with you was when we went down to Atlanta, when we did 12-hour ride in 6 hours.
12-hour ride in 6 hours. Also, during that trip, that we both loved. We loved it. We loved being with you. But you remember how we had to really coerce you into allowing us to go to the bathroom? Yeah. Remember that? So finally you did stop, but you put us on a 10-minute leash. We had to hurry up and go. We had a good time, though, Patrick. It was wonderful.
The most precious thing I remember about you, when we first met, you was holding Ashley in Detroit, and you looked at Ashley, you looked at Rodney, and you looked at me, and you said, "Hey, dude, you gotta marry her." And I laughed. Rodney smiled, and a year later, we was married. Thank you so much.
My favorite memory of you is listening to reggae music and laughing at family get-togethers.
Ever since I can remember, you've always been here for Nicole and myself. And I must say, my fondest memory of you is when you walked me down the aisle 20 years ago.
And we still going strong.
Your best character trait is your innate sense of leadership. I remember we were both working at Ford Motor Company. I was working in medical. You were on afternoons. You were the shift supervisor. Ike Askew, Tom, and Sean were getting their vision and hearing test done. And I asked Ike Askew, I said, "Ike, when is my husband gonna go on days?" And he said, "Never." And I said, "Never?" He said, "No, I'm never going to put him on days." And I said, "Well, how come?" He said, "I can't run it without him." I said, "You can't run it without him?" He said, "No." And then Sean chimed in. She said, "Well, I hope he's getting compensated." And, you know, and then Tom said, "Well, Ike, is he getting compensated? How much does he make?" And Ike looked at Tom and, as a matter of fact, said, "He makes more than you." So I would say you were running things at Ford Motor Company. Everybody knew it. You had leadership traits. Every time I have a question about leadership, you always tell me, "Veronica, do whatever you need to do to get the job done." And I thank you for that.
What is our favorite characteristic about you? And I have to say, mine would be your sense of humor, as well as you don't really sweat the small stuff. And I feel like I need that, because you know I'm so tightly wound and everything makes me mad. I'll call you like, "Dad, such and such said such and such." And you'll sit there and you'll be like, "And that really made you mad. But why are you mad about that? Let that go." And that's just how things are with you. They're so simple. This, why does that bother you? Stop taking stuff so personal. Let it go.
Dad, your best character trait is that you are dependable. When I was at the University of Michigan for graduate school, I didn't have a car, and you literally drove me home from Ann Arbor every single day in rush hour traffic. And that went on for months. Every single day you would drive me home. I could always count on you to be there and to get me home safely, and I'm really grateful that you did that.
Best characteristic of Patrick is he's a boss. He knows how to be a boss. Learned that from his mom. He can be a boss. I don't know if he's going to take orders, but he can sure give orders. I found that out early. That's a good thing about him.
Your best trait? Being candidly honest is your best trait, which is hard for some people to accept, but that is your best trait. You do not know how to be fake, and I love you for that. Which goes with something else. Your other best trait is, and you taught me this, is to how to deliver sarcasm with poise, to the point where some people don't really know if you are joking or if you are serious. They don't know how to take it. And I love that you taught me that. I can't say I'm ever be as good as you are at it, but I appreciate it.
You've always been very eloquent and well-spoken. You know, you have this gift of gab, man. You're very generous, man. I mean, thanks for sharing your room with me when I moved in. You know, everybody don't do that. I don't know if I could have done that if it had been the other way around. That'd probably been a hard pill to swallow, somebody taking up my space. But you were generous enough to invite me into your space. So I appreciate that, man. That's a trait that everybody don't have.
I think you have many amazing traits. One being your amazing father, you're a wonderful brother, you're loving, you're kind, you're giving, and you are extremely funny.
What is Patrick's best character trait? I'd say you're witty and humorous. You always make me laugh.
Witty and humorous. You are funny. You are witty. You can have a little bite to it, though.
Yes.
It can be a little bite to it. You've bitten me a couple of times. I didn't really care for that, but because you're my godson, I went along with it.
Something you've taught me is simply to let things go. Trying to hold grudges. I'm still working on that. I'm a work in progress. But those are two things that you've taught me, and two things that you do yourself too. I don't know for you to hold a grudge or stay mad at someone for super long. That's a great quality.
You taught me to seek out knowledge. When I was a little girl, me and Amber, when you were talking to us, you never dumbed down your vocabulary. You would use these ridiculously huge words, and me and Amber had no idea what you were talking about. We'd say, Dad, what does that mean? Or Dad, what are you saying? And you would tell us, look it up. And sometimes we did. And it taught me to never be intimidated by the words that someone uses, that if I'm not sure about something, I can seek to find the answer. And that gives me confidence in whatever arena that I'm in.
Also, over the summer, you took me driving and taught me the importance of being a Black young man in America and police brutality.
And the last thing, something I learned about, that learned from you, Patrick, I'm gonna say I learned how to drive, and I thank you.
What I've learned from you is that life is good, don't sweat the small stuff, and just live in the moment and just relax. It's okay to be stress-free. So for that, I want to say thank you.
That's a good one. I did all the teaching. I guess I'm a boss too. we learn from each other, I guess. Just being each other's company, we learn a lot from each other. That's a good thing.
One of the things that I did learn from you is how to be responsible. I watch you closely, as you are my big brother, and learned early on from you that, you know, you were very responsible and you stood up to your responsibilities and as a man, and I appreciate that.
Happy birthday, Patrick. I hope you enjoyed your day. You're really old. You're like my oldest cousin, but you are my fifth favorite. You used to be my 15th, but you moved up. So something you're getting better with time. And I do enjoy our Sunday visits. I do enjoy our bickering and our smart remarks to one another. I don't know what I would do without those. I love you, and may God continue to bless you with many, many more years. Or bless us with your presence for many, many more years. I love you, cousin.
What up, though, cuz? We wish you a happy birthday and many more to come. You know, me and my mother both love you. That's from both of us. Let you know you're one of my favorite cousins. I think I never told you that. But You know, you're like a low-key comedian to me. Every time we hook up, crack me up constantly. You know, we always have a good time. I look forward to seeing you again, cuz. Enjoy your day.
Happy birthday, Uncle Patrick.
Happy birthday, Patrick.
It's love you so much.
We love you, yes. Happy 60th. It's a big birthday. We hope you have a great one.
Have a great day. Love you.
Love you.
Hey, Uncle Patrick. Darius here. I wanted to wish you a happy 60th birthday.
Happy birthday, Patrick.
Happy birthday, Patrick.
Happy birthday, Patrick. Well, over the years, I have had so much fun with you. From the time you were a little guy to the time that you are the good-looking, charming, well-educated, wonderful man of 40 years old. It's just wonderful having you for a godson.
Just wanted you to know that it's really a blessing having you in my life.
Happy birthday, Patrick.
Happy 60th birthday. Look forward to our next gathering, cuz.
Love you. Have a wonderful birthday. Have a great 2021. And I wish you nothing but the best of the best. Talk to you later. Bye.
I love you. I'm so glad God chose you to be my father. I feel like we fit something like a hand in glove. I love you 1,000 times over. Happy birthday, and I hope you enjoy your day.
Dad, I hope that you have a wonderful day. I hope that you enjoyed this video. We love you, and we thank you for being in our lives. You are truly loved, Dad. Have a wonderful, blessed 60th year.
I just want to wish you a wonderful, happy 60th birthday, and I hope this year brings you nothing but joy and blessings. Yeah, I love you.
Happy 60th birthday, Grandpa, and I love you.
Happy birthday from my family to yours. I just want to wish you many more birthdays. I love you so much. Words cannot express how blessed I am to have an amazing brother like you. I love you very, very much. And I can't wait to celebrate more birthdays with you. God bless you and may God keep you. And I love you again.
Patrick Stewart, 60 years old. Happy birthday to you. I will always love you. You will always be in my heart. And I think about you all the time. Happy birthday. Bye.
Happy 60th birthday, my brother. And I'll say I would be remiss if I didn't mention your mother, Patsy Ann Stewart. You know, you guys share a birthday together, and also I know this would have been a big milestone for her as well. And I have much love for you and the family. Thank you, Amber. Thank you, Courtney, for celebrating your father. All right, my brother, much love to you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Granddaddy. Love you.
Not ever say the word. He said, what's that going to spread?
Thank you.